Hi, good morning, everybody. This is Sam Sia here from Kuala Lumpur. We're having our weekly Kangen Disputers meeting. Okay, with me here is my co-host, Michael Saul. And today we have a very unusual person. When I say unusual, it's a student. Imagine a student becoming a full-time Kangen disputer without getting into the workforce. So how many of you would like to have a student becoming your Kangen disputer full-time from a show of hands? Or you can type it in the chat box. You can type in number one there. Okay. So Rushab, are you there, Rushab?
Yes, Sam, I can quite clearly hear you. You hear me, Sam?
Yes, we can. So but before that, let me just introduce Michael. Michael, and this is Michael Saw, my co-host. Okay. Michael, you want to say?
Thanks, Sam. By the way, for those of you who are new to Sam, Sam is our dynamic team leader for Full House Power. Let's give him a big round of applause for arranging such kind of wonderful activities, full of value to every one of us. Right. Thank you, Sam.
So. Yeah, go on, Michael.
Today we have got a wonderful speaker, Yang. For the past few weeks, we have got a lot of engineers, professionals sharing how they have, you know, from zero to become hero in our business. And for this young man, I think you're going to make waves. Not only that, you're going to give a lot of inspiration to many of us. This young man is called Rushab Kalia, and he was a 18-year-old student when he started this business. Can you imagine a young person studying? Now, most of us would imagine that these people would have no market potential, and that's what most of them would say. But yet, he's able to make a big breakthrough to become a Kangen 6A2. This is a wonderful guy we should hear from. Kalia, if you are ready, let's give Kalia a big Rushab a big round of applause to encourage him, to give him power so that he can share with us his journey in Kangen. How from zero he's now become a hero 6A2 with us.
Thank you so much, Mr. Michael, Mr. Sam Sia. First of all, before I get started, I really want to take this opportunity, join my hands and say thank you to Mr. Sam Sia and Mr. Michael Saw to give this opportunity to me to share the little experience I have in my energetic journey with everyone over here. Along with that, I also want to join my hands and really thank each and every person attending this training right now from all over the world, to everybody from India, to Kuala Lumpur, to all around the world. I really want to say thank you that you all chose to come on this session and hear what I have to share. Now, before I move any further, I really have one thing that I want to make really clear. What I'm going to be sharing today, I do not teach. I cannot teach. I do not teach. And a lot of times what happens is a lot of people say, "Arey, how is this young guy going to teach me?" I don't teach anything to anyone. What I actually rather prefer doing is I share my experience, and if that experience works out for you, makes sense to you, you all can definitely apply it and probably get some results. I am not going to teach anything to anyone. I'm just going to be sharing my experience. So if everybody is excited to get this meeting started, can we all put number one in the chat box? Can we all go in the chat box and put number one? Young guy going to teach me. I don't teach anything to anyone. What I actually rather prefer doing is I share my experience. I think you could hear myself yet again in the background from somewhere. No problem. Perfect. So what I'll be doing is I'll actually pull up my presentation so I can share it with each and every one of you right over here. Can everybody see my presentation?
Yes.
Perfect. Thank you so much, Michael, for prompt feedback. Thank you so much. Right. So basically, this is me. My name is Rushab Kalia. I'm from India, particularly in Mumbai, the city full of Bollywood, you know, all of us around the world have heard the city full of Bollywood celebrities and all of that place. I live in Mumbai. I was born on 21st July 1999. That means only about a month ago, I have turned 21, which is 100% legal to do anything adult like in India. So I've just actually turned an adult. But as Michael said, I actually started my Enagic journey at the age of 18. That means I got my Enagic business ID when I was 18. But the first time I actually saw the Enagic Kangen Water presentation, the demonstration, and the EKW that Sam Sia and Mingwei conducted in India for the very first time back then, I was only 16 years old. So I'll share a little bit about myself, about my journey, and how it's been a humbling experience, how it's been a learning experience for a young chap like me to achieve whatever little I've been able to achieve in my Enagic journey. Right. So what we'll do is let's get started. So I'll give you, I'll try and brush through my background a little quickly. I don't want to talk too much about my background, my focus. I want my focus to be all about the Enagic journey. So I'll give you a little bit about my background. Now what I'm going to be doing is I'll keep sharing as in when I'll just keep telling you what I learned from a certain situation. Now the reason why I'm sharing my background particularly is a lot of times when I come across a lot of distributors in Enagic, or at times when I was doing what I was doing, a lot of people told me, yeah, you only extraordinary people, only special people can become successful. Now, when I share my background, I just want all of you to know that I also was just an ordinary kid like any other kid y'all might have or y'all know. So if I give you a little bit about my academical background, I was always an above average student. Basically, I was never the topper of the class. Until standard one, I was the top of the class. I scored about like 99.9%. But as in when the standard kept going up, my grades definitely did coming down. But around in India, the standard 10 is considered as the pivotal moment wherein you go out of school and now you got to look out for your college. So around standard 10, I luckily did take my academics a little seriously. I had a target of about 75% that I wanted to score. And by hard work and by God's grace, I definitely ended up scoring 79%. So I was very happy. So because of my grades, I got the college I want without any donations having to be made from my parents to the college for my admission to be done. So I got my college on my own merit, just like any other young guy. So academically, I've always been very average. After my schooling, a lot of people think that I've done a lot of business related, you know. I took up commerce, I went into sales trainings and all of that. I did none of it. I picked up arts. Now, in arts, I particularly picked up psychology as my subject. Because I really was interested in what a person thinks. Why does a person do what they do? Because I think if we can figure that out, everything else can be understood and taken care. I think that's also what we probably look forward and understand in sales as far as I have learned. So basically, I was academically a very average child, rather than above average child. Coming to my younger days, into other than academics, I've always been a very active guy, a young active guy. Now, what I mean by this is I was always a very participative kid. May it be poetry recitation recitals, I'd be on the stage. May it be dancing on the stage, I would be there. If it was playing the guitar on the stage, I would be there. If there was probably some show going on in the school, I was called on the stage to take, you know, compare the whole show and, you know, be the MC in a way or two for those people who don't, who would like to understand. So basically, I've always been a very active child. My parents always made sure I was participating in something or the other. Victory, no victory was a completely different thing. Because my parents taught me one thing very clearly, that it is very important you participate rather than just wanting to win every single time. Winning is important, but rejections are a part of life, right? So I think this is one thing I really picked up very early in my life. So this was about my profession, about my life before all of this. And third and the most important thing that I think everybody attending this session today needs to know about what I did about my background is I started very young professionally. Right, I was quite young when I started my professional career in Enagic. Now, how many of us really think that it is important to start early? It is very important to start young in whatever you want to do in your life. It's very important to gain experience early on in your life. If we believe we need to start young, can we all go in the chat box and type the number one? Right, it's very important. Thank you so much. I really appreciate all the feedback all of you are giving. Thank you so much. Right, so basically I was a very active guy. I started early on in my life professionally in terms of my career. Now, when I say early, I don't mean the 16 years of age when I actually saw Enagic and decided I want to get involved. and talking even before that. So if I tell you, the next slide over here, for you, those who do not know me or what I've been doing, I had been around the age of 12. Yes, you heard it right. At the age of 12, I decided I was going to be one of the world's youngest trainers and motivational public speakers. So basically, all the guys you see on the stage talking and, you know, doing all of those conventions and seminars around, I decided I want to do that. Now, how I got to that point is a completely different story, and I wouldn't be able to fit it over here and also do justice to the topic of Finagic. So that's probably a conversation for a different time. But basically, what I understood is that I understood that anybody who's ever made it supremely big in his life. And you know, I'm sure all of us in the background over here can see a book by the name 10X. I think Sam Sia recommended that book to me. So 10X is a book you can see right here in my background in my library. So I really saw that any person who's ever gone 10X, that is, has made it big in his life, has almost always started early. Now, if I give a few examples, if you all agree, no, you can just raise your hands as and when I'm talking, so if you agree or not. Mark Zuckerberg from Facebook started young, yes or no? Definitely yes. What about Steve Jobs, the founder of Apple, the biggest consumer brands when it comes to cellular devices and all these other products? Did Steve Jobs start young? Definitely he started young. He was very young when he started the company. What about Bill Gates? All of these guys started young. I mean, they kept doing what they were doing, but at the same time, they made sure they shift their focus towards their careers as well. Now, the reason why I feel it is very important for us to focus towards our careers as well is I have a very simple philosophy. Sam, Michael, sir, if you all agree, you all can also just give me a feedback if you all agree with whatever I'm sharing. I'm only sharing right now. Perfect. Thank you so much. So basically, I believe it is very important one should start young, one should start early, is because when you're young, we have a lot of time, we have a lot of energy, and our finances are mostly taken care by our parents. So we have a lot of time to try, experiment, keep doing multiple things, and even if we do fail, we have gained experience. We don't fail. In as young guys, no matter what we do, we never really fail. Correct. Right. And see, I can see Sam in the chat box saying he's only 60. So I'd love to cover that in the next point I'm sharing over here. Right. So I always believe that it's very important you start young, because probably by the time you're 25, 26, 27, that's the age wherein responsibility starts coming on your shoulder. You know, you have your responsibility to go out and earn now, because probably your education is your academics are over. You've done your higher education, all of those things. So now you've got to be the bread earner for the family. You've got to go on a financially supportive family. You've got to take care of multiple things in terms of responsibilities. A lot of people want to start their family by the time they're at that age. But when you're young, when all of us are very young, what we don't understand is we have no responsibilities. We have nothing to take care of other than our own life. Not what we want to achieve with probably the next 10, 15, 20 years. And I think the sooner we start, it's like a catapult, you know. You go and you have a big head start compared to the other people out there in the market. Because when you're young, we have a lot of choice. We have a lot of chances. We have a lot of options to explore. Not necessarily probably the first thing we might do makes sense. Might give you the success you need, but when you start young, you have a lot of scope for rejection. And I think that is one thing I have learned from any successful person, may it be Sam, may it be Michael, may it be anybody big I've heard, may it be my parents. I've heard only one thing and one thing only: you have to fail. You have to fail, make mistakes. You have to make mistakes often. And if I say make mistakes early, because when you make all these when you make so many mistakes, right, that basically means you've been putting in a lot of action. It's said that when you're having problems, problems come only to people who've been working hard. If you have not been working hard, there are no problems. Am I right, Sam? This is what I believe. This is what I have understood out of whatever little experience I've had with my life. So basically, moving forward, if I share a little bit of my experience about being the world's youngest trainer, I have been invited. So I was only about 12 when I started approaching schools that, you know, I have a module. I worked very hard to create that module as well. So I used to approach schools and colleges with my own brochure saying, hey, I want to come and talk to your students. Please give me about 1 hour of their time in your auditorium. And almost 7 out of 10 times, I'd be pushed off, made fun of, and rejected. As a young guy, I not just didn't get entry in the schools, but I had to do a lot of I had to find a lot of loopholes around on how I can even get in front of the principals to get the opportunity to pitch what I want to do. So So initially I started talking to a lot of schools and colleges, school students who were about my age. So I was about in 7th standard. So I used to speak to students of 7th and 8th standard. But as in when I kept working on it, as in when I kept growing older, my experience started gaining from multiple things. Right. So I started being invited to students who are much older than me. So probably if I am in standard 8, I used to be invited to speak to standard 10, who are probably 3 years elder to me, 2 to 3 years elder to me. So it was a very fun experience. Initially, I did not get a lot of opportunities. I'll share about this as in when I move forward in the presentation. So I started speaking to a lot of school guys. Little by little, I started getting invited to colleges. I myself had not even completed my school, but I was invited to colleges. People who were completing their degrees, people used to be MBA institutions. I used to call to all of those places to give a talk. So it was really amusing to see that people much older than me sitting in the audience trying to learn something from the little experiences I've had from here and there. Now, at this point, right, I want to share one thing that can really help all of us in Inagic and any entrepreneurial venture, but over here, particularly in Inagic. And this is one point that my parents really firmly taught to me. And my parents taught me one thing which has always stayed with me is, do not let your problems and challenges be a barrier to your success. I'll repeat, do not let your problems and challenges be a barrier to your success. So at that age, when I was 12, I had two barriers particularly. Now, what were those two barriers? Number one, as you all can guess, I was too young. People used to make fun of me for being too young. What will a 12-year-old kid teach? It was a really difficult thing I had to get over. And number two was, how do you have the experience? Because speaking, training, coaching, grooming, all of it is not about just taking a walk and giving a talk. It is about walking the talk. It's about doing what you're doing before you preach it, right? So I had to work really hard to get what I wanted to achieve. But initially, as I told you, out of 10 schools that go and pitch that I wanted to talk, out of those 7 people would say no. Out of those 3 people who used to give me a chance, only one of them would probably give me the opportunity for 1 hour to talk to your students. And I had to do it for free of cost. So I did that for about one and a half years. I went to schools and colleges. I kept pitching myself to multiple schools with my own brochure and my own face on the brochure saying that I want to talk to your students. For one whole year, almost 9 out of 10 times I got rejected. I kept doing that for 1.5 years. So I think this was one of the very important moments of my life that really shaped me in terms of facing rejection. By the way, before I move forward, I really want to ask a very simple question. How many of us feel bad when we feel rejected, when we hear a no? How many of us feel bad? I used to feel bad. That's why my hand is up. So if you feel bad from a no, you can go and type number one in the chat box. Please go and type number one in the chat box. A lot of people feel bad when they hear a no. I also used to feel bad when I used to hear a no. And I think we also have a lot of young guys other than me, right? We have Sam. We have also Simon on the platform over here. Hi, Simon. How are you? Right. So basically, all of us have gone through. So I can see a lot of people mostly just putting one. Some of them have been putting two. So for most people, right, I want to do a small experiment. Sam, can I do that small experiment with all of us? I want all of you to please type a no in the chat box to me. Type no. Everybody go in the chat box and type a big no. Right. Everybody is saying a no to me. I can see so many no's. No, people didn't participate in typing one as much as they're participating in typing a no to me. Right. Now, what I'm trying to say is, even though there are so many no's coming to my side, is it really bothering me? Does it really matter to me that I am getting so many no's? Is it? It's definitely not. Because when you say no, the person who's saying no to you is not saying no to you. He's saying no to the opportunity you are providing to them, the possibility that could have been there. They're not saying no to you. No is simply next opportunity, new opportunity. They will come back. You have to focus that when you work hard, when I work hard, when all of us work hard, we just need to focus on, okay, no is not the full stop. No is just the comma. Now you begin. So I think for the first 1.5 year, I did that. For 1.5 year, I went to all of these schools, got rejected, even though I was offering my services to them for free. Guess what? After 1.5 year, I had created enough demand in the market because my work, they said, was good. I was really good at speaking to people around. So they started calling me now. So I started getting calls. Rishabh beta, can you please come to our school and talk to our students? I said, sure. So as in when the demand kept going up, I started charging money for it. So initially, the amount of money I used to charge was very minimal. I used to charge about 5,000 rupees for about 1.5 hours of talk. I think that was quite reasonable as a young guy around 13, 14 years old. But as in when I started growing older, the demand kept increasing. I started being invited to a lot of famous colleges and universities in Mumbai. I started being called to a lot of corporate offices as a guest speaker over there. I started raising a lot of money for NGOs, quite popular NGOs for farmers and all these other places. So when all of this started happening, I knew my demand was going up. So I started realizing that because I'm charging less, people are not taking it as seriously. So I had to up the price. I want to share at a certain point in my speaking days, I at the age of about 15, used to charge about 15,000 to 20,000 rupees for about 1.5 to 2 hours of talk. That is basically about 2 points of 2 in commission in Energy for one sale. I used to charge for 1.5 to 2 hours of talk in the school. So basically, this is what I used to do. I have also been featured in the newspaper, Times of India. There's a big newspaper in India. I've been featured as been an article. And I've been in magazines also. So enough about my background now. I think we've heard enough about my background. Basically, what I wanted to share is I have just been an ordinary guy who kept working hard persistently, consistently, and being patient. Knowing that to create something big, you have to give it time. I'm sure Mr. Michael will definitely agree with me on this, right? So I think over here, I just want to share a few, 3 pictures with you about how towards the end when my speaking days were really good. These were a few images. I'm very happy. These are my favorite pictures from my speaking days because these were probably one of the biggest audiences I've handled at a certain time. Initially, even 10 students were not given to me. Towards then, a lot of them used to love coming and having a speaking of interaction opportunity with all of those guys. So I feel really humble to all the people who said no to me and all the people who also decided to give me a chance. Right. Perfect. So I think from here, I will now focus all about Enagic and what I feel about Enagic, what I have learned from Enagic, that probably some of y'all from whatever I'm sharing could take from my little experience. Are we all ready to jump right into the Kangin zone now? Are we all ready? Are we all excited? If we are excited, go in the chat box and can you please type KW, yes, Kangin water. So by the time everybody puts Kangin water, I'll drink some Kangin water and supercharge myself so I can maintain this level of energy and keep going forward. Perfect. I hope everybody's been drinking, they have their Kangin waters around and you're supercharging yourself as well when you're going through all of these Kangin experiences. Perfect. Thank you so much. So I have a quote I have lived by probably all my life. Now I know my life is probably lesser than what most of y'all professional careers have been so long. My whole lifespan hasn't been as long as your professional career. But whatever little life I've lived, since my professional career started at the age of 12, every single seminar I have always conducted has either started or ended with this quote. Now I'll read this out. You are never too young to start a business empire, and you are never too old to chase a dream. Right. Now I would love to share an awesome example over here. You found out that I'm one of the youngest. You're never too young is right in front of you over here. Never too old. We have one of the biggest distributors on planet of Earth of Enagic Kangin water with us, Mr. Sam Sear. And he's about 60, and I have never seen Mr. Sam act as if he's 60. He's always young, he's always supercharged, he's always traveling, he's always empowering people, he's always inspiring people to grow big, to get big, right? So I was gonna give the example of Captain Sanders, the founder of KFC, but I think I don't need that anymore because we have all such amazing people like Mr. Michael Song, Mr. Sam Sia. We have so many people from even India, Mr. like Uma Ma'am and all of these people. But even though the age is more, but the willingness to create something is not gone. So I think age is just a number in Enagic or anywhere, particularly in Enagic. A lot of times people say, okay, you don't have the experience, you're too young. Please do not let things like that, those come in your way. Because age is just a number. I love it when people say this hasn't been done before. You cannot do it because this hasn't been done before. Because when I do it, I become the first ever person who did it. And now I am an inspiration model for a lot of people to follow. And I think that is all that everybody wants, to create an opportunity, create possibilities for others to create something really meaningful and that you can support from your end, right? I think we all want to contribute in one way or the other for other people's success. Now, I've always been asked, what are a few things you really need to keep in mind? How do you find out what is it that you want to do, right? So I am going to share about 3 to 4 things over here. Number one thing you have, all of us have to keep, I kept in mind when I was thinking about what I want to do, my purpose, so to say, is number one, what is it that you are good at doing? What are you good at doing? That's number one. Number two, do you love doing it? Because not necessarily just because you're good at doing something, you really love doing it, right? So number one, are you really good at, what are you really good at? Number two, do you love doing it? Number three, does the world really need that in terms of value addition in the world? Well, is what you're good at doing, what you love doing, is that something that the world really needs in terms of value addition? And fourth and the most important, can you get paid for it? Can you get someone in the world, a few people, a few thousand people, to get pay you for your services, pay you for the value you add on this planet Earth? Does anybody want me to repeat these four things? I'll repeat this once again. What are you good at doing? Do you love doing it? Number three, does the world really need that thing in terms of value addition? And fourth and the most important, will you get paid for doing it? Because I think a lot of people miss out on the fourth one, they don't think about the world is going to pay them for or not. Because no matter what you do, even to do good work, you need money in your pocket. Even to do charity, you need money in your own pocket. I think someone is writing something on the screen, I think. Yeah. Perfect. So basically, that's the philosophy I've understood. So basically, this is what it is. So, you know, if I compare this to Inagic, now let's take on one of the biggest reasons why I think Inagic is the thing that is for me. And probably all of us can relate through this example also. Right, number one, what is it that we really do in Inagic? When we want to do the Inagic business, now let's talk about business a little bit. What is it that we really do when it comes to Inagic? Can you all put it in the chat box, please? What is it that we do in Inagic? What skills are required? What do we really do when it comes to doing the business? Can you all go in the chat box and write what is it that we do in terms of doing the business? Okay, so I'm getting an answer. We do a lot of sharing. There has to be a lot of compassion. Okay, what else? Okay, we have to do sales. Okay, there's sales that we have to do. We have to add value. That's fair. What else? We have to interact with people. Communication. We have to interact with people. I think basically there are only three things that we do in Inagic. We interact with people. We need to have good communication skills. And last but not the least, we have to create this business in such a way that it's simply duplicate. It's about only 3 to 4 things like that. Am I right, Mr. Sam? Would you like to add anything over here? Perfect. So basically, these are the 3-4 things that I figured out we need in Inagic. So when it comes to, are you good at what you're doing? Now, I know I am good at my communication skills. I know I'm good with interacting with people. And I know I can add value through the Kangen Water presentation. I can add value to a lot of people. I can show a lot of compassion. I can help people in their health. So these skill sets that are required in Inagic, I am good at. Or if all of us are new, any of us are new over here, coming from a young guy like me, I just want everybody to know, if a young guy like me can learn all these skills from here and there, please remember, every skill is learnable. It will take a little bit of time, but every skill is learnable. And every skill is learnable. You could be from whatever background, but if you dedicate a little bit amount of time, about a month or two, and you dedicatedly focus, you can learn any skill you want, right? So I understood that the circle number one to the left, what am I good at? I knew skills required in Inagic, I can get good at it. If I'm not good at it right now, I can get good at it. Number two, do I love doing it? Now for me, you already know my background. I've always been a people person. I've always been a person who loves performing any kind of art on the stage or in front of people. So I knew what I have to do in Inagic is something I'm going to love all throughout my life. I love interacting with people, awesome people, like everybody over here, right? And number two, communicating with them as I'm doing right now. I love sharing. I love talking. I just, Mr. Michael, I'd love to share one small thing that I used to write on my brochure when I was young in my speaking days. And it's very funny, if you all like what my brochure tagline was, you can go in the chat box and you can type, wow, right? So the tagline that I used to follow back then was, I was thrown out of the class because I was talkative. Today, I am invited to give a talk. Right, I'll repeat. I was thrown out of the class because I was too talkative. My teachers used to be like, oh my god, this guy is all over the place. Throw him out, he's distracting everybody. To a place wherein now I'm invited to give a talk. Right, so this was a tagline I used to live by. So, I know. So basically, in Enagic, the things I have to do, I really love doing. So, box number two is also ticked off for me. Number three, does the world really need it? I have a very simple question. Does the world really need Enagic Kangen water? I think the world definitely needs Enagic Kangen water. And does the world really need good distributors like Mr. Sam, Mr. Space Curly, Mr. anybody? For example, I don't call myself a good distributor. I think I'm just a learning distributor, getting good. I don't think I'm the best distributor you should aim to be like. Right, I'm getting there. So does the world really need Kangen water? Yes, definitely. So box number three is also ticked off. Am I right, Mr. Sam, Mr. Michael? Right. And fourth and the most important, will you get paid for it? Do we get paid for doing Enagic business? Yes or no? Answer should be a big yes. Right? Enagic takes care. Enagic has this amazing philosophy, right? You take care of other people's health, you build up your own financial security, and we'll take care of your finances also. So all of these four boxes really connected with me on a very personal level. And by the way, our Enagic product is a Japanese product. Am I right? It's a Japanese product, right? We trust Japanese people in their philosophy of health and their purpose of life. This philosophy that I'm talking to you about over here, this philosophy is also a Japanese philosophy, which is called as Ikigai. I-K-A-G-A-I. Ikigai. There's an amazing book that you can pick up from Amazon and you can read that book. So this star that you can see, right, that we call purpose in the Western world. In Japanese, this is called as Ikigai, the purpose of your life. How do you find the purpose of your life? So probably for this Japanese business, Japanese amazing product that we do for this Japanese-based amazing company, right? By the way, is Enagic an amazing company? If yes, please raise your hands. I can see everybody over here. Can we please raise a hand if you feel Enagic is an amazing, amazing company with an amazing, amazing product? Perfect. So I use the Japanese philosophy like Ikigai to understand, do I really connect well with a Japanese product and a Japanese business? I think all of you all can also use this little thing I did that helped me understand on how powerful the Japanese philosophy, the Japanese mindset, and the Japanese products altogether are. Right, so let's move forward now. So I'd love to share a few key points in Enagic with everyone over here, what I feel about key points. Number one, very important thing is I came in only as a customer. So basically one of our well-wishers had recommended Enagic Kangen water to us, particularly for health purposes. My mom had a little bit of some health challenges. So particularly for health benefits, we bought the Kangen machine. My mom dad actually went and saw Ming Wei and Mr. Sam Sears' presentation for the very first time in a banquet hall here in Mumbai. So just like anybody who attends the Kangen water presentation for the first time, they come back home and they feel so good, they can say only two things. Yeah, this product looks good and this product is very healthy. Other than that, no matter how much you try to remember that oxidation reduction potential or the emulsification, you don't really remember those words. So when I asked my parents on what this product was, they weren't really able to give me an answer. They said it's a good product and it's a very healthy product. So what my parents recommended, the next day Ming Wei was going to do the same presentation yet again in one of the banquets. So I decided, why shouldn't I just go there and see the presentation myself? So I went there, I saw the whole amazing presentation of the Enagic Kangen water, and I understood one thing and one thing only, that this, again, just like my parents, I also understood two things. This product is really good and this product is really healthy. So we took the decision. My mother actually flew to Malaysia to buy this product because back then the Enagic Indian office was not even established. My mom flew to Malaysia, bought this Kangen machine. The machine came home, we started using this water only as consumers. And I think this is a very big advantage I have on my end. Now, there's a reason why I say advantage. because a lot of people, when they come in for the business, now they don't really understand the product really well. All people focus on is how I can sell. And one thing I've learned in sales and marketing, I have only learned from a lot of people, learned a lot of people's experience, that become the product of a product. And so in Enadic, I became the product of my product. So I really studied the product really well. I started using the product as effectively as I could, and I got the results. Much later, I found out that Enadic was really a business also. Right, so that was number one. Number two, as I told you, my mother bought this product to us. It's also my mother that actually started the Enagic business for us. My dad was busy in his family business day job, and I was busy with my speaking career. So I'd love to share some pictures of my mom, who actually started taking this Enagic business in full speed. So my mom's been a speaker, trainer, and my mom's been a teacher and all of that, right? So my mom has always been open to talking publicly, but my mom has also been very reserved when it comes to sales. My mom was not a person who would be glad in sales, you know, push people, follow up people, prospect and all of that. So, but even though a lady like that, so my and my dad's confidence really came up when I saw my mother get really passionate about the product. And I saw a person like her who's very reserved in sales also going out of the way, also traveling around India, also traveling to Malaysia to buy this machine, to attend seminars and training. As you can see, she's doing a presentation over here. And the pictures on the right. So these were the moments wherein we figured out, okay, this opportunity is really worth our time. And I'll be very happy for you to know my mom's work on Enagic Kangen Water has been empowering a lot of female entrepreneurs in India, to an extent that my mom was featured on one of the news channels for her work on female entrepreneurship. So I think my mother deserves a big round of applause from all of us. And you'll also be very happy to know, a person who was so reserved when it comes to sales, my mother became the third ever female 6A in India. I think that also deserves a lot of, my mother also deserves a lot of credit for that. She was a big inspiration for my dad and I. So when I saw that, I understood one thing. Enagic is not easy, but it is definitely simple. Easy and simple don't have to be the same thing. Enagic was simple because it was so duplicable. You just had to follow what the other people do, get good at it, and make sure you can teach others doing. So Enagic, I feel, is the best business anybody can ever do, right? Because honestly speaking, you don't really have to use your own brains. You have to use your own brains when it comes to how to talk, what to talk, you know, how to convey yourself. But when it comes to doing the steps, right, it's already laid. The blueprint is there. Don't go to reinvent the wheel. Just follow what these successful distributors are doing. And that's exactly what I did. Number three was, I always wanted to be an entrepreneur, but I never knew how to be, because I was a young guy. I was never from the engineering background, so I didn't know how to make a product. Mathematically, I wasn't so good, so I couldn't come up with some mathematical formulations that I can provide. I knew one thing, I wanted to do business. I was good at sales, I was good at people, and I was good at communication skills. So I think Enagic gave me the best opportunity there is around. You know, it is always said that, you know, people don't like to do their dirty work. People only want to, you know, be on the stage, do the sales and all of that, like it's seen in the Bollywood movies. But real entrepreneurship, real business building is not like that. But in Enagic, literally, you know, I'm sure all of us have been, a lot of us are big fans of Bollywood movies, right? You know, Bollywood always shows, you know, the bigger than life, the bigger than life picture of everything. So in Enagic, that is really the case. All the other work, all the difficult work, like making the product, taking care of the warranty, the deliveries, everything, having a head office, everything has been taken care by Enagic. All you and I have to do to call ourselves entrepreneur is just make sure we know how to do sales, and just make sure we can make other people healthy. I do not know, I haven't come across any other product, any other business that is this simple. Number four, Enagic's credibility. Now, I think all of us should be, really benefited a lot from the coming 2 points. Because Enagic has a credibility of about 46 years today, if I'm not wrong. Right, 46 years. Now, a person like me who's just rather turned 21, I don't have a lot of credibility in the market, even if I started my Enagic journey today. A lot of people don't really trust me because I haven't built that credibility in the market. But today when I stand in front of my customers, when I stand in front of my family members, pitching them the Enagic Kangen machine, it's not me. It's Enagic's 46 years of credibility standing behind me as a superhero saying, ki, I am going to make sure Rushabh doesn't fail. I am going to make sure Rushabh's reputation gets built. I am there to take care of Rushabh no matter what. I just need someone who takes me up rightly and takes me to the right people. I am there to make sure none of you all fail. I am going to make sure none of you all fall. Your immunities get built really well. So I think Enagic, for that matter, turned out to be a superhero for me, for a person like me who's so young. So Enagic's credibility really helps. Number five was global business. I think I heard Hemant talk about from, I think, 2 months back. And Hemant gave a very beautiful example wherein he said that, you know, there was a point if he would have continued doing his day job, his office could have been really fancy. But one place office could be really fancy. But next picture, he showed the whole map of the world wherein Enagic offices are there. And now he said, initially, that could have been my one office. Today, I have my offices around the globe. And that is exactly what I wanted. I wanted to have a global business. I wanted to travel around the world, meet a lot of amazing people like all of you all over here. This opportunity would not have been with me if I did not join Enagic, right? To interact with people on a global scale. So next point was the concept of true health really connected with me. I really feel that the concept of healthy body, healthy mind, and healthy finance is really important to maintain a balance between all of them. If all of us agree, we can please go in the chat box and type true health. Can we all go in the chat box and type true health? Right. So basically, I believe that natural health is not natural anymore. Just like how common sense isn't common anymore, natural health is not natural anymore. Now the reason why I believe so is because anybody over here attending this is about 35, 40, right? All of you all would have understood one thing, that you guys don't really fall ill as much. You guys don't really have a lot of health problems as much as probably my upcoming generation has. Probably the younger generation of mine also does. But particularly from my generation onwards, the problem of young people falling ill, young people having a lot of diseases very easily, immune system not being too strong, has really started from about my generation. And the reason for that is most of y'all who are old enough to understand, the reason y'all don't fall ill, why I feel, is because you guys grew up in a time when the pollution wasn't there, when the radiations weren't there, basically when the world's health was not really bad. But today, young guys like me have to grow up in environments wherein the world health altogether is really low. So whatever immunity my body is building is also not that top quality as all the other people around. And I think that is the reason products like Enagic Kangen Water is really important, because Enagic Kangen Water makes sure, gives you the health benefits of how those people back in the day got. I think that is one thing that Enagic Kangen Water does really well, that it takes care of 70% of your body to the most optimal level ever possible. Right. So I think this is one thing that is very important of maintaining not just a balance, but also living your life naturally. Because from 11.5 pH water, at a lot of times I wash all these so-called organic vegetables. I am shocked to see, I'm heartbroken to see a lot of times even these organic vegetables at times have so many chemicals coming out of it. So that's what I feel, that natural health is not natural anymore. But with Enagic Kangen Water, I can lead my life and I can create my immunity as strong as anybody else in the world and probably go on to live about 100 years, right? So next was, one more reason why I took Enagic business very seriously is because the people I knew around me were taking Enagic seriously. Now, as a young guy, I didn't have a lot of experience. I didn't know how to do the business a lot. I didn't have a lot of my own brains there when it came to business. So what I started seeing, people around me who are much smarter than me when it comes to this space, for that matter, it being my parents. My parents have been one of the biggest supporting factors for me in Enagic Kangen Water when it comes to guiding, grooming, and coaching me. People like Sam Sia, right? Who I knew around, and I knew that these guys are much smarter than me when it comes to Enagic business. And so many other people, I see a lot of top doctors and scientists using Kangen Water. I started seeing a lot of celebrities around drinking Kangen Water. I think for those of you who don't know, in India, as I said, there's a lot of Bollywood, right? You'll be very happy to know a lot of those Bollywood actors, producers, directors and singers are my customers. I've been very privileged and I'm very humbled to say that I have got the opportunity to sell a lot of these celebrities Kangen machines. Right, so I wouldn't, and every time I meet them, right, I always make sure whenever I post it on this, when I post it on my Instagram or my YouTube or anywhere I post a picture or a video with them, right, I always write one thing: look where one opportunity, one right decision got me. So this is one thing very important. And I saw my chachu, I think today we all heard the example, sharing of Mr. Vinod Kalia, heart patient. He's my dad's elder brother, he's my uncle, he's my chachu. And so I started seeing him take this Enagic business seriously. So I said, if all the people smarter than me today are taking Enagic business seriously, why shouldn't I as well? Why should I miss out on the opportunity? Because back then, a company had competed almost 40 to 41 years. I said, without me, the company worked for 40, 41 years. Without me also, this company will go down. So I feel it is very important that all of us should make sure that we don't miss out on opportunities, because opportunities knock our doors once or twice. But after that, it goes to the next one. So whenever we do get an opportunity, I think we should grab, I at least feel that you should grab the opportunity by hand and get the best out of it. And last but not the least, the potential. I think the NIATIC business potential is tremendous. When I was very young, right, my dad told me to write a big goal for myself in terms of financial stuff also. You know, how much do you want to earn probably about when you're 25? I'm sure Simon is also as young, so he must have done the same thing in his life. So, you know, set a big goal for yourself. So I did, amongst the many goals, I had also set a financial goal for myself, which at that point was probably 20x bigger than what I was or what we were as a family. And that number was probably a monthly recurring number. Now, in NIATIC, what I'm very happy to say, the potential for a young guy to really achieve their dreams, goals, and for anybody for that matter in NIATIC, so no matter what your background is, what your gender is, what your age is, NIATIC sees none of it. NIATIC sees only hard work, consistency, and patience. If we can keep all of these things right, keep doing, I am so happy to say that the target I had set for, the big target I had set for myself at the age of 25, given the speed at which I'm growing my NIATIC business, the trajectory I'm going, probably 2 years, I'm 21, by the time I'm 23, I'll hit that number. So 23, that number would be hit with my active efforts, right? My goal is by the time I reach 25, that big number becomes my passive income efforts, right? Does it make sense to everybody? Perfect. So I think these were a few key points that I thought would be really important for people like us in NIATIC, for all the amazing distributors, young, old, from whatever background you're educated, not educated, none of it really matters. And so I just showed the pictures to you, to my mom. I've always believed in one thing. Someone definitely very, very smart said, work hard and take chances when you're young, so you can enjoy and tell stories when you're old. I've always believed in this quote ever since I started my professional career. I started working very hard. Even today, a lot of people ask me, why is it that you're taking NIATIC so seriously? Now, when I say young over here, I don't really mean young in terms of age. Yes, that's definitely there. The sooner you start working, the faster you'll be able to enjoy your financial freedom or success or whatever it is you're really going after. But I really feel that when it comes to living the life you want, even in terms of NIATIC, when you start the business, don't say, okay, I'll do it as it comes, as it goes, I'll keep doing it. I think that is the wrong approach for me to take. It's very important that we should take the opportunity when we have it and go all out massive action. I think this is one thing also Sam really taught me, to go all out massive action. And I think I've been trying to apply that myself and make sure my whole team applies that as well. And I think it's been a great journey making sure. So I think over here, what I'll do is I'll quickly brush through a few important things that I feel as a young entrepreneur, that I made a lot of mistakes, but I made sure I get these things right that worked out well for me. And probably these things are working out well for a lot of other distributors, successful distributors as well. So what I'll do over here is I'll take one point, I'll probably expand over it for about a minute or two. All the Kangen distributors, successful Kangen distributors who've been doing this, right, including Mr. Samsia, Mr. Sudesh Kalia, anybody and everybody, Mr. Michael, I'd love for you to just give me a thumbs up if you feel that the point makes sense, right? Perfect. So please understand, the point number one is, please understand NIATIC is a business. If you're in here for the business, this is a business. You have to treat it like one. Now, a lot of people want to do the NIATIC business, but they want to do it their way. They want to do it how you probably do your regular day job. That's how you have to do the NIATIC business. Mr. Sam, can you please unmute yourself? I would love to just have an active conversation with you as and when we go ahead. So, sir, do you agree with this point?
Yes, I'm here with you.
Okay, sir, do you agree with this point that people need to take up NIATIC if they want to do the NIATIC business? They have to take the NIATIC business up like a business.
Of course.
Right? Because I think a lot of times, because when it comes to business, right, I always believe one should start right. Now, what I mean by starting right, I think this is also something that we all discuss in the training, that you should start right. Now, I think how I started right was, number one, as we can see, know what you are getting into and what it will take for you to achieve what you want to achieve. Just like how you want to buy a product, right? Mrs. Sam, I'm sure Mr. Sam will also agree that before buying a product, we do so much research. All our customers do so much research because they want to know what they are getting into. Similarly, if you're in here in NIATIC for the business, I think all of us should really find out what we want to do. You should. So what I did is I started seeing successful people like Ming Wei. I started seeing successful people like Cynthia Brigandi. I started seeing successful people like Mr. Bernard, Mr. Sam, all of these amazing people. And I reverse engineered what these guys did. I understood what I'm getting myself into. So please, friends, I have one thing that I really wanted to share over here, that NIATIC because it is a business. Any business takes about at least 4 to 5 years to properly set up, wherein you have a whole team in place and all of that. Mr. Sam, do you agree to this? It takes about 4 to 5 years to set up a stable business.
Sometime more,
right? Definitely, but at least a minimum of half a decade, right? So that is number one. I think all of us should really know what we're getting into and work on it accordingly. Inagic does not work on how I want it to work. Inagic works the way it works. And no matter how I would want it to work, it will work only the way it has to work. Number two, know your why. And I think this is one of the most important things. Would you agree, sir?
Absolutely.
Absolutely, right? What I mean by know your why is a lot of times people, when I interact with people, I usually tend to ask them on why is it that they're doing the Inagic business. And I don't mean harm or bad, or I'm not trying to be mean or rude to anyone. But a lot of times I just see that the why of why they want to do the Inagic business is really lazy or really weak for that matter. A lot of people, when I say, they say, Inagic was a good opportunity, I want to make the most of it. I don't want to lose the opportunity. If that's the case, your why is not really strong. Be very clear on what you want to do. If you want to do the Inagic business just to earn some extra money per month, even one sale a month is okay for you. Let's say you're a young guy, you have 30,000 rupees salary. If you do even one sale, you make about 13,000, 26,000 rupees eventually. That's a good number for you probably. But if your goal is to do the Inagic business as a part-timer, as a full-timer, the way you operate will be completely different. Am I right, Mr. Sam?
Yep.
Right. So it is very important, I feel, because I think all my mentors around the world have always taught me that know your why. Because once you know your why, how to do it, what to do to get where you want to get, is all a step-by-step process that comes to you. All of that is learnable, but why is something you give out. Number three is learn from successful distributors. Now, this is very important. All my life, whatever I am, it's only because I just kept learning from amazing people from around the world. May it be my parents, lucky for me, my so-called uplines were my mom and dad. So I was around them the whole time, but I just want everyone to know that my journey in Inagic has not been easy, if not 10 times more difficult. Because probably someone who's grown up, who has a network, when you talk to them, when all of y'all talk to your customers, they take you seriously. At least they give you a thought. For me, when I pitch my people something, they don't even take me seriously. What I say is not taken seriously. So a lot of times that was a really big problem for me, because I had to work 10 times more to make sure I look right, I have my hair right, I talk a certain way, I know how the grown-up people talk in terms when it comes to business and sales and all that. I had to be something 10 times bigger than what I was to make sure people take me seriously. So initially when my Inagic journey did start, I just kept learning from my mentors around. And trust me, luckily for me, my parents were there, but you don't really need physical mentors around. Nowadays, I want all of you all to make sure you make the most of the trainings that happen. Number two, and the most important, internet is such a beautiful platform. Internet is such a beautiful platform wherein you can connect with the best of the best of the best and learn from them. And literally, that is all I have done. I don't believe education restricts to the four walls of the classroom. Education is all about learning from wherever. Today I traveled to Singapore. I remember, I think I met Mr. Bernard as well when I had gone to Singapore. I went over there for a certain training. I went to the Inagic Singapore office. I got a sale done over there. So I traveled all over India. I traveled all over the world to learn from the top mentors, top trainers. I sit on the internet and I keep learning every single day from amazing people. I attend all of these meetings regularly because I want to learn. The more you learn, I think Mr. Sam will definitely agree with this. First you learn, then you remove the letter L. So then you only earn. First you learn, then you remove L. Right. So last but not the least, take ownership of your business. A lot of times I feel this mistake has also been done by me initially, by us rather initially, and my team. And again, a lot of other people, but I've made sure we've rectified and we don't make this mistake anymore. Now, I also want everybody to know that my parents really kept me really religious and spiritual from the very beginning. So I've always believed in one thing, that no matter what happens, God's doing it for a reason. So I've always believed in that. So what I mean by this is, at times there'll be situations that I, or as a family, we feel were really unfair for us to do, to go through rather, because initially the Inagic journey wasn't really smooth for us. For about the first 6 months, we made zero money. Yeah, one sale, two sale done. And after that, for about a year or two, zero sales. Because we didn't have a mentor, because the person who introduced to us, for whatever reasons, we had a little bit of a clash with them, or not a clash, I'd rather say what's the word for it? We had a difference of opinion together. So after the first and second sale, because they had the experience, but we parted ways, we didn't really get the support. So at that point, it felt really unfair on, you know, why is that we have to go through it? But that that moment really was the pivoting moment for our Enagic career, because we understood that, okay, there's nobody coming to save our Enagic business but ourselves. We have to make sure we take the full ownership. So if that wouldn't have happened back then, if for whatever reason, whatever happened, if the person wouldn't have walked out, we probably would have still been dependent on those people to help us for the presentations, demonstrations, everything. But because that happened, because the person who we started off with, for whatever reason, we had a difference of opinion, we decided we have to take full charge of not just our business, but also be so strong that we create a whole empire. I took Mr. Sam Sia and Mr. Ming Wei as my major examples. Like, even in India, there are so many people like Girish Kapoor, people like Samir Poddar. These guys are such supportive people. I thought I have to be like those guys. You know, become so strong that you can't just sustain yourself. You also make sure you create a team, you provide other people the opportunity. Perfect. Thank you so much. Sure. I think about 2 to 3 minutes more, and then I think I'll be wrapping my talk today. Perfect. Thank you so much, Will. So basically, this is what I feel, that a lot of people, no matter how young you are or how old you are, if you have your, if you're doing Enagic full-time or you're doing Enagic part-time, you have to take some ownership when it comes to doing the Enagic business. Not forget even doing the Enagic business. Enagic products are so amazing. I'm sure all of us believe in that. I think Enagic products deserve a loud round of applause from our shaky hands over here. Right. I think it's very important, because Enagic, even when you recommend the Enagic products, if you say, I saw this product, have a look, there's a high chance people might not really consider buying. The reason Enagic sells only on direct sales, because once you own the machine, there's ownership. When you drink the water, you experience the benefits. Then when you talk to someone, right, you talk to all of them with ownership. Okay, I am using the Kangen water machine. I know the health benefits. I want you to come and have a look. There's a certain level of ownership, there's a certain level of seriousness that pops in when I think we all take anything, we take ownership out of all of it, right? So I think with this, I think before I move to the few pictures I'd love to share with everybody over here, I just want to say one thing, and one thing only, that Enagic has definitely been a big roller coaster for me, because I know initially I started my Enagic business at the age of 16 and a half, 17. I started working on my mom and dad's business ID. So I remember I used to pack my dad's bag. I used to be his assistant, so to say. So I wouldn't give the demonstrations. I'd pick up his bag. I would pack his bag. I would throw the water. I would fill the water. I used to drive the car. I used to be the assistant boy. Right? What that helped me do is I learned from all of them. Whenever there was a presentation by Girish Kapoor, by Mr. Samir Poddar, I'll attend. Whenever there was a training, a lot of times people ask me, I think a month or two back, Sam sent on his broadcast list a screenshot of his chat in mine. In that, if you have quite clearly read, I have attended the EKWs more than 29 to 30 times. I have attended the Essential Kangen workshop more than 29 to 30 times. Right, and not just in Mumbai, I travel all over India wherever that training is happening with my team over there. To an extent that today I don't just attend, I also give that Essential Kangen workshop to my fellow Kangen distributors in India. I get called to different parts of India to conduct that Essential Kangen workshop. Of course, my inspirations have definitely been all those amazing Kangen distributors, including my mom and dad, right? Perfect. I was also there in Lucknow. Someone in the chat box said I definitely is there. Even Thomas keeps doing a lot of trainings in India, so I also traveled all around to learn. So, Enagic's been a beautiful journey. It's been really difficult. So I remember when all the three of us at my house, we're one of the only families in India where all of us at home are 6 years and above. So I became the youngest 6 at the age of 18, but that was not the first time someone from a family went on the stage. Every single time when any of us was given the award of being a 6A, it was a very emotional moment for me and for my family, because we know the amount of risk we had to take. My dad quit his day job wherein he used to earn about 1.5 lakh rupees a month. We know when that happened for approximately one whole year, there was no sales, the amount of money coming in was zero, the EMIs were really high. All of that was going on. So we know how much of a struggle it's been, from creating nothing to everything. So even though I feel really humbled that Mr. Michael at the very starting said from zero to hero, sir, I don't really feel I'm the hero. I think for me, it's my parents who are the heroes, who really set up this business the way they've set up, and they've supported me. I just feel I'm a small guy in Enagic just yet, working very hard to creating a big possibility for myself, becoming a global youth icon, just like how Simon is, or how Ming Wei is, how many other Enagic Kangen distributors are. I really feel humbled for this opportunity, and before I move, before I end the whole thing, I just love to show two pictures, two to three pictures. Is that okay, Mr. Michael? Thank you so
okay.
much.
Okay, go ahead.
So this is the picture when I first saw, the picture to the left is the present of the day I saw my first ever demonstration with Ming Wei. And the picture to the right is the first day ever when I attended the Essential Kangen workshop. You can see I have a picture, and I've made sure that every single time I meet Sam and Ming Wei, I take one picture with them. So with Ming Wei, so it's now become like a tradition with Ming Wei. So whenever even Ming Wei sees me, Ming Wei says, come, let's take a picture for this time. It's been a very beautiful journey. I've created a lot of amazing friends in the process. I've made a lot of great mentors who I'm very lucky to have been constant touch, and they know me. Not just me knowing them, but they also know me, and they coach me, groom me, and guide me on what to do, how to do. Right. So I think this is one of it. And again, just like how Sam and Ming Wei are considered as the father-son duo from Kuala Lumpur, right, to the world from Kuala Lumpur. I think from India, I think it is my father and I who represent the father-son duo in India to the world, right? So this is also something we made sure that every single time me, my dad are there along with Sam and Ming, we take this picture together. I have a lot of more pictures, but these are the two pictures wherein I was looking really good. So I definitely picked these pictures to upload. So I really thank all of those guys. And I also want to share one thing. It's not just, I also want to give credit to the whole Sia family, because it's not just these two guys who've been working. It's also Cora ma'am who's been really putting a lot of effort. As a family, they've been growing. Just like how the Sia family is from Kuala Lumpur to the world, I think the Kalia family from India is from here to the world, because my dad's brother is achieving, Vinod ji is achieving 6A this month. Right, my mom became the third ever lady 6A in India. I became the world's youngest 6A, if now the 6A2. World's youngest 6A2. Right, my dad is a 6A. So 6A2 rather. So basically in my whole house, all of us are 6A and above. So this has been a beautiful journey for me. I really want to take, and I just want to show that initially when we started the business, right, you can see initially we used to take buses and travel. We used to travel in trains at times to save money. Because I know that because for the first year, the money was not really coming in, so spending wasn't a good option for us. So I remember to get where we wanted to get, we used to travel in train for 3 days to get where we wanted to get. And back then we had to carry 3 bags. One Kangen machine itself, Kangen demo bag, and a shoulder bag full of my clothes for at least half a month. Because if it's taking you 6 days to go just up and down, you're not going to go there for only 2 to 3 days. So back then the hotels you used to live in, you weren't as classy and luxurious and posh as we all like to call it in entrepreneurship. You know, people want to see the end picture, you know, living in fancy hotels, traveling in all of these airplanes, driving a nice car, buying all these expensive things, making investments. But I think Enagic is really entrepreneurship at its purest and entrepreneurship at its simplest. So I remember, as you can see, you know, in the three pictures only you can see a big difference between the quality on my travel. Riding towards the left, you can see in the middle things did get a little better. Of course, rejection and doubt has been one of the biggest fuel rather for me in Enagic, because as you can read down, my dad and my parents and my mentors always taught me one thing. Pay the full price of success, because the cost of failure is really high. So I've always believed that I have a long way to go. 682-3 was the first base camp I set for myself in the whole Everest journey, big journey of me. I compare my Enagic journey to an Everest climb. From the very bottom, the top position that I can see is 682-3. But I know when I reach the 682-3, there's way, way, way more to achieve, way more to climb, way more to go forward. So this is just, so today, you know, it's very, I'm very thankful to Enagic for this opportunity that I've gotten to meet all these amazing celebrities, to create a team all over India. And luckily also internationally, I'm starting to trickle around even internationally, you know, to create a team. I travel a lot. I have a lot of amazing people by my side. I have a lot of people's blessings by my side. And yes, today we bought two cars from Enagic, from the business of Enagic. We've made a lot of investments, a lot of things. And today travel is good. I travel only by flights now, to save time, because now time is money. The amount of time I probably initially would have wasted traveling, now I can make a few sales in that time. So I think now that all makes sense, but I think initially people really underestimate on how important it is to think local and then go global. People think global and don't even start local. Think local, then go global. Start working from where you are. Start working small, because I forgot the author that really said this. Anything worth doing, anything worth starting is worth doing poorly. It's okay if we all do it badly. And before I end on the whole presentation, I really want to take this opportunity and thank my family, my mom, my dad. My dad's name is Subesh Kalia. My mother's name is Naina Kalia. And I'm really, really, really thankful. I really want to join my hands and I really want to say thank you. Because right now you see me over here. But there have been a lot of people behind me, a lot of people who supported me, yes. A lot of people, a lot of amazing mentors like Sam who have helped me get where I am and inspired me. That's definitely there. A lot of people who definitely said no to me, rejected me. A lot of times people call those people haters. I don't call them haters, because maybe their intention for me is not to fail because they don't want me to. They just care for me, so they say, okay, don't get into this, you might fail. They're really concerned for me, so I don't call them haters. But again, rejections are rejections. So I thank everybody, but amongst all of them, I want to thank three people. My dad and my mom, who've been there by my side since the very beginning. I owe all my success, I owe everything I am to all of these two amazing people. And also, I want to take this opportunity and say thank you. And I want to appreciate my girlfriend for being supportive of whatever I've been doing since the past 6 years now. So I really want to take this opportunity to say thank you to everybody who's given me the opportunity right now to talk to all of you amazing people here. And I really feel really, really, really humbled at this moment to... I think someone on the screen is writing, thank you, I really appreciate. Thank you so much, I really appreciate.
Thank you so much, Rushabh. Thank you.
Let's give Rushabh a big round of applause.
Thank you so much. Thank you
for
so
his
much
inspiring speech. Yeah.
I think I just
right. Okay, thank you, Rushabh, once again.